This lesson begins by reviewing the two-dimensional linear programming problems that high school students often solve in their Algebra 2 classes. Then it extends the equations to n dimensions and captures the essential intuition that optimal solutions are at the corners of the feasible region. And we state this rigorously with the fundamental theorem of linear programming. And finally, the lesson will cover the simplex algorithm, a very practical way for solving these optimizations. There are many good references on linear programming. This treatment will follow most closely David Leuenberger's linear and nonlinear programming. Before we begin, however, I should mention that parts of this lecture will use notation and some ideas from linear algebra. For notation, we will use capital letters for matrices. Thus, A might be this matrix here. For column vectors, we'll use lowercase letters. So X might be this vector here. Also, we'll often use the lowercase version of a matrix to indicate a column. Thus, A2 here refers to the second column of the matrix A. We indicate the transpose of a matrix by giving it a T in the superscript. And this just reverses the meaning of the rows and columns. This notation then allows us to use C transpose X for the dot product. This is a row vector times a column vector, which ends up just as a single entry matrix, which by convention we'll interpret as a scalar. As far as concepts go, the ideas of how to represent a system of equations as a matrices, of linear independence of vectors, matrix rank, and matrix inverse should all be familiar. If these ideas aren't familiar, then it would be a good idea to refresh your understanding before watching the rest of this lesson. As always, it is recommended that you watch with pencil and paper handy so that you can pause the video and work out details on your own as needed.